Okay, generally what goes wrong with most Sony VCRs is this little arm here doesn't operate properly. The arm takes the tape up here behind the pinch roller or the capstand. So in order to remove it, what'll end up happening is that it will not come back all the way. It'll end up staying right about here. What you want to be able to do is push it up, and it should just spring right back like that. I've already done this one, but basically to remove it, you need a 4.5 millimeter socket. You just loosen it, okay? And then there's a little plastic clip. You either rotate this till it's past the plastic clip and kind of wiggle it up. And then what I usually do is clean it out and apply some oil to the shaft, the inside of the hole, and then put it back down again. You can see that there is some oil in there right now. Okay, and now it works properly. Now I'm just going to show you what it looks like when it loads, what it does. It actually pulls the tape around the capstan, so you'll see it here. Watch. So the arm is actually over here right now, and it has the tape behind the pinch roller and capstan. Okay, so the other thing that happens when you put the cassette in is the tape will get pulled out by these two P-guides on either side, and then it gets wrapped around the video head like this, goes across the tracking head, around through the pinch roller, and then back into the cassette. Okay, so I'm just going to show you how it ejects, and you'll see that it'll unload the tape. Now these are the two P-guides right down here. These are the two P-guides there and there. Okay, and occasionally the one on this side here, the gear breaks on the back, so it will be sitting out here instead of back here. You always got to watch that, because the tape won't load properly. You'll get no video image if that happens. So we'll just watch it load again. And then I'll push play here, and you can see the tape as it's moving. Okay.